President-elect Joe Biden has formally introduced his national security team to the nation. It came today as the presidential transition officially got underway after a three-week delay. White House correspondent Yamiche Alcindor begins our coverage.
Well, good afternoon, everyone.
America is back. That's the message President-elect Joe Biden and his first six cabinet picks hammered home today in Wilmington, Delaware. As they took to the stage, Mr. Biden declared a break with the last 4 years.
It's a team that reflects the fact that America is back, ready to lead the world, not retreat from it.
The members of that team include Antony Blinken, a former top State Department official as Secretary of State, Alejandro Mayorkas, as Secretary of the Department of Homeland Security, the first Latino and first immigrant to hold this position, and Avril Haines as Director of National Intelligence, the first woman to head the intelligence community. Vice President-elect Kamala Harris praised the selections and the man who chose them.
I look forward to working alongside them on behalf of the American people and on behalf of a president who will ask tough questions, demand that we be guided by facts, and expect our team to speak the truth.
If he's confirmed by the Senate, Blinken will inherit a legacy of global relationships in disarray from the Trump administration. Today he spoke of his late stepfather, who survived the Holocaust as a child in Poland.
At the end of the war, he made a break from a death march into the woods in Bavaria. From his hiding place, he heard a deep rumbling sound. It was a tank, but instead of the Iron Cross, he saw painted on its side a five-pointed white star. He ran to the tank. The hatch opened. An African-American GI looked down at him. He got down on his knees and said the only three words that he knew in English that his mother had taught him before the war: God bless America.
Mayorkas also talked about his family history.
My father and mother brought me to this country to escape communism. They cherished our democracy and were intensely proud to become United States citizens, as was I.
I accept this nomination. No.
Haines, who was deputy director of the CIA from 2013 to 2015, will take on the job of leading and revitalizing the intelligence community, which outgoing President Trump has frequently criticized.
To our intelligence professionals, the work you do, oftentimes under the most austere conditions imaginable, is just indispensable.
Mr. Biden also introduced Linda Thomas Greenfield as the United Nations ambassador, Jake Sullivan as national security advisor, and former Secretary of State John Kerry as special presidential envoy on climate change.
President Joe Biden will trust in God, and he will also trust in science to guide our work on Earth to protect God's creation.
Thomas Greenfield, a 35-year veteran in foreign service, emphasized the importance of reestablishing global partnerships.
America is back. Multilateralism is back. Diplomacy is back.
All of this on the day after Emily Murphy, the head of the General Services Administration, officially ascertained that Mr. Biden is president-elect. That move authorized the transition to officially begin. President Trump said yesterday that the move was in the country's best interests. But today he fired off another tweet saying, quote, the GSA does not determine who the next president of the United States will be. He also made a historically quick appearance in the White House briefing room. In a one-minute statement, he praised his administration's work on the pandemic and the economy.
The stock market, Dow Jones Industrial Average, just hit 30,000, which is the highest in history. I just want to congratulate all the people within the administration that worked so hard.
I hereby grant you a full pardon.
The president did find time today to carry on the annual tradition of pardoning the National Thanksgiving Turkey. He again made no comment on the transfer of power or his legal team's efforts to overturn the election results. Meanwhile, today, three more states, Pennsylvania, Nevada, and Minnesota, certified Biden victories.
And Yamiche joins me now. So, Yamiche, you were at the news conference in Wilmington, Delaware today, where President-elect Biden introduced his national security team. Tell us what struck you about what they had to say about their mission, their outlook as they begin this next administration.
Well, President-elect Joe Biden and his picks for cabinet-level positions were all hammering home the point that they are going to see a sea change away from President Trump and his view of America as isolationist and pulling back from the world and going toward this Biden-Harris view of the world as a place where America should again be engaging with our allies, again doing things like leading on climate change and the policies impacting globally how the environment is handled. They also, in some ways, were talking about their experience in government. A lot of these picks that Joe Biden went with, they are steeped in government. They're people who are alums of the Obama administration. Now, there are people, critics, that are already saying that some of these people are too elite. We saw Senator Marco Rubio attacking the fact that some of them are Ivy League graduates, saying that they're going to oversee the decline in America. So even though Joe Biden is feeling very good about this group of people, you're already starting to see the partisan politics at play. And of course, many of them are going to have to be confirmed by the Senate. So we should watch this space.
And Yamiche, you also reported on President Trump's two brief appearances today at the White House. What more do we know, do you know, about how he's handling this moment?
Well, President Trump and White House aides are really sending contradictory messages. President Trump is still lashing out, still very angry, saying that he recommended that Emily Murphy at the GSA do this and move forward, while Emily Murphy is saying this was an independent decision. He's still saying he can win. But then we saw Joe Biden just in the last few minutes here talk to reporters saying that he felt that the White House was being very cooperative and that they were getting a lot of help. The other thing that we see is Emily Murphy, with some reporting today, she was ready to be fired when she made that assertion yesterday that Joe Biden was the official winner of the election. So that also tells you the mood within the federal government. There are things definitely still moving along with all federal agencies now in touch with the Biden transition team, but things are still very, very tense as the president continues to lash out. And he had that quick White House briefing, the shortest that I can remember of his tenure. So we have to continue to watch the president continue to be angry.
No question about it. Yamiche Alcindor reporting again on both the incoming and outgoing administrations. Thank you, Yamiche.
Thanks so much, Judy.